Hey y'all, good afternoon. It's Ned over My Philippine Dreams running solo today, live from Pink House in Dumaguete. There's a typhoon outside, so we're filming inside. Yes, it's once again the backdrop of our cheesy couch and the curtains. A couple people have been asking me what kind of town Dumaguete is and what kind of expats and foreigners live here, so I thought I would briefly, hopefully, address that. I can best describe Dumaguete as a sleepy seaside town. It's officially a city, but it's only got about 130,000 people. That population swells to about 400,000 during the day with all the influx of students and outside workers coming into town. And for me, it's about the perfect size. It's not too big, it's not too small. It's like the three bears and that Goldilocks chick. I looked around before I finally settled here. I went to some other places briefly to check them out, and they were either too big or too small. Dumaguete is about just about the right size. It's not a party town. It's not a crazy nightlife town. We only got two real clubs. We got Zanzibar, which can get really crazy around 3-4 o'clock in the morning. And we also have Why Not, the infamous Why Not. Other than that, you get some sports bars, you get some other bars, you get some, you know, places to go and soak up the suds and all that. But overall, this isn't like Makati, this isn't like Manila, Angeles, Cebu, that have a lot more clubs, a lot more party atmosphere, where you can be dancing till dawn and partying like it's 1999. I actually had a guy, he was 27. He's like, hey Ned, I like to party, I'm in college, I want to go to school there, and Dumaguete looks great, but I like to really party and have a great time and stay up till dawn and stuff. And I'm like, I don't know if really Dumaguete is for you. It's a quiet town, it's a mostly peaceful town, it's the city of gentle people, and there's a lot of students. Types of foreigners that are in Dumaguete. These are basically two types of foreigners that are staying long-term in Dumaguete. First off is the students. You have students from all over the world going to school here. I'm attending Silliman, Foundation, NORSU. You have people from Korea, Japan, America, Australia, New Zealand, Africa, coming from all over to take advantage of the school system here. For the Americans and some other Westerners and Europeans and stuff, it's to take advantage of the low tuition. You can actually go to medical school here in Dumaguete for about $1,300 per semester, which is a pretty good deal, and you get a lot of bang for your buck. So there's actually, I'm running into a number of younger Americans that are doing their pre-med requirements here in the Philippines, and they're going to transfer back to the United States. You also have a lot of Asian students from Korea and Japan coming here because of the English that is widely spoken. They're able to get an education and work on their English at the same time. So you'll see lots of students, and you can usually identify them because they'll be on skateboards, and they'll be really young. The other type of foreigner that you'll most often encounter in Dumaguete are family guys. This is a big family guy town. You got a lot of guys that have been married. Some of them have been married for years, decades. They got kids, they got family, they've settled down, they've put down roots, they're part of the community, and that's what they do. They're happy here. I know a number of guys that have come here, and that's what they wanted to do. A lot of guys had been through a divorce, been through some bad relationships, and they had come here to start anew, to start afresh, not to necessarily reinvent themselves, but to give happiness another shot. And from what I see, 99% of them are succeeding at that. And I get a little jealous every now and then. What you won't see, what type of foreigners you won't see around Dumaguete, you won't see a whole lot of sexpats. There's not a whole lot of prostitution, not like Cebu, Makati, Angeles, Manila, all that. And there's just not much opportunity for people to come down there and do that kind of recreation in Dumaguete. The city isn't geared for that. You also won't see a lot of playboys. You won't see a lot of chick boys. You won't see a lot of serial daters. You have some guys that come to Southeast Asia and they're like, I'm going to play the field. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. The two-week millionaires and all that. And Dumaguete isn't really the town for that either. Because again, you have about 130,000 people here. They all seem to know each other. They're all on Facebook. And in Dumaguete, most of them are Tevezes. There's like 105,000 Tevezes in Dumaguete out of 130,000. So they're all networked. And once word gets out, you know, this guy's a playboy, this guy's a chick boy, he's not serious, he's just playing the field, that person's opportunities for recreational activities diminishes. And they usually move on. So that's about it. that's the type of town Dumaguete is. I love Dumaguete. I call it home. Whenever I'm out somewhere and I'm coming back on the ferry or whatever, I always, whenever I see the lights of Dumaguete in the distance, if the ferry's coming in at night, it's like, ah, home. Or if I see the smoke rising from the city during the day, it's like, ah, dirty home. It's a great town. It's easy to get out of. You can, 15 minutes heading north, south, or west, don't head east because you'll be in the ocean, and you're in waterfalls, you're in Twin Lakes recreational area, you're in Darwin, snorkeling with the clownfish. It's just the perfect little town for me. It's not for everybody. There's other places. I mean, if you really want to live well and live the high life and all that, Makati, areas of Manila are really high end. They got really high expensive subdivisions and all that, like super, you know, starter castles and all that. That's the place to do that. Dumaguete isn't really that. Dumaguete is more like a middle class type thing. So that's Dumaguete in a nutshell. That's the type of foreigners you'll encounter in and around Dumaguete. Until next time, this is Ned over my Philippine dreams. See you later.